Welcome to the intro to the chemical thermodynamics playlist. So when we're talking about thermodynamics, we usually have some set of some initial conditions in a system, and then some process occurs, and there is some final set of conditions. And these conditions, or whatever change occurs during this process, is usually specified by some type of physical quantity, which can be measured. So examples of certain types of these processes would include things like a gas, which it can either expand or compress, so the expansion and or compression of gases. We could have two different solutions and we could mix them, or for example dissolving a solute into solution. So solution mixing is an example of some type of process that fits this type of motif. We can have phase transitions, things like ice melting to become liquid water, liquid water evaporating to become water vapor, those types of phase transitions. And another thing which we're most interested in overall in this playlist, which would be chemical reactions, the changing of a set of atoms from one set of atoms and molecules, and then rearranging their bonds to form a different set of atoms and molecules. So those are some examples of these types of chemical and physical processes which can occur to bring us from some initial state to some final state of a system. And then we can also track the physical quantities which can be measured during such processes. And examples of such physical quantities could include things like, if we have a gas, for example, we could measure things like pressure, volume, temperature, and number of particles, things which we're familiar with from the ideal gas law from general chemistry, PV equals NRT, particle count. We could measure things like energy. There are various types of energies which we'll look at. Work and heat, things which occur during the physical process, things which exchange, and then other quantities which we'll go into in more detail later, things which you've had some basic experience with from general chemistry, things like entropy, enthalpy, and free energy, which we'll delve into in much greater detail and at a deeper level than we've seen before throughout this playlist. Okay, so those are some examples of the types of quantities and processes that we'll look at over the course of this playlist. And there's two different approaches that you generally see when you're talking about thermodynamics. We have classical thermodynamics, which is the original form of thermodynamics when it was first developed in the 1800s. Classical thermodynamics is primarily concerned with macroscopic quantities. So, for example, an entire cylinder of gas, an entire beaker full of a solution, an entire handful of some chemical. And it's primarily measured empirically. These are all things which have been measured over time. The laws of thermodynamics have just demonstrated to be empirically true and stood the test of time. And so the experimental evidence has mounted such that we have three laws of thermodynamics that we'll talk about. And thus, we're taking generally a top-down approach, meaning that we're starting at the behavior of an entire cylinder of gas or an entire solution, and then taking that down to, well, what must the molecules inside the solution be doing if that is indeed the case? And then we have what we'll also look at a little bit in contrast to this, which is statistical mechanics, which instead of being macroscopic, prefers to look at the microscopic versions of things. Statistical mechanics will start at single molecules, the properties of a single molecule, and build its way up, primarily as a theoretical framework, which is then just justified by the validity and scope of its conclusions. And as I said, statistical mechanics is a bottom-up approach We start by looking at the properties of a single molecule or a few molecules, and then derive up from there what must the behavior be of an entire cylinder of gas or an entire solution of some liquid or some mixture. So this is what we're going to look at primarily in this playlist. We're going to look at things like these different quantities of energy and heat and work. We're going to look at a little bit of statistical mechanics, looking at the microscopic level, and then try to use that to explain and understand better these empirical macroscopic observations, which form the bulk of thermodynamics.